Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us first acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. We repent to you, the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who open your kingdom to those who are humble and to little ones, lead us to follow trustingly in the little way of St. Teresa, so that through her intercession we may see your eternal glory revealed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Rejoice with Jerusalem, and be glad because of her, all you who love her. Exalt, exalt with her. All you who are mourning over her, oh, that you may suck fully of the milk of her comfort, that you may nourish with delight at her loving breast. For thus says the Lord, lo, I will spread prosperity over her like a river, and the wealth of the nations like an overflowing torrent. As nurses, who should be carried in her arms and fondled in her lap. As a mother comforts her son, so will I comfort you. In Jerusalem, you shall find your comfort. When you see this, your heart shall rejoice, and your bodies flourish like the grass. The Lord's power shall be known to his servants. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response. In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
O Lord, my heart is not proud, nor are my eyes haughty. I busy not myself with great things, nor with things too sublime for me.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
Nay, rather, I have stilled and quieted my soul like a weaned child. Like a weaned child on its mother's lap. So is my soul within me.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
O Israel, hope in the Lord, both now and forever.
In you, Lord, I have found my peace.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples approached Jesus and said, who is greatest in the kingdom of heaven? He called a child over, placed it in their midst, and said, amen, I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever humbles himself like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For a couple years, I got a call at 3 o'clock in the morning from a friend of mine. He asked if I could come to the hospital that his wife was being induced labor, even though the child was only 5 months. She herself was in danger, as well as, obviously, the child. I left, went to the hospital, found my buddy Brian there, and when I went to see, his wife first, they had already taken the child, and she said to me, "Can you do me a favor?" I go, "Yes." I said, "Well, I'm going to anoint you." And she goes, "Don't worry about me. I want you to go and baptize Matthew." Why she chose Matthew? Because it was on his feast day. And so I went. I had the nurses instruct me where to go. And I went to where the infants were held, and I was led to this, no bigger than this, it looked like, actually it kind of looked like a clear thing that you put over a meal, you know how you have those silver platters with the cover, that's kind of how it was shaped, but it had holes in it, it had tubes in it, and there was monitoring everything the child had, his breathing and everything, what was going on. And I said, "I'm supposed to baptize, the child." And the nurse goes, "Well, okay, that's fine." I go, "Is there anything I have to do?" And I said, "Is it okay for me to use water?" And she says, she goes, "Oh, that's fine." She goes, "Here, I'll remove, the thing." And I go, "Well, I don't know if that's necessary. I don't want to cause any harm." And she goes, "No, it's perfectly okay." And she says, I said, "But so tiny." And she says, "It's okay. If you wish, please feel free to pick him up. Pick him up and use him the size of my hand, no love. That's how big he was." And I said, "I'm so afraid. I see he looks so fragile." She goes, "Just so you know, we have to pick up that child regularly, at least every 15 minutes. Even though it's getting the perfect nutrition, the perfect hydration, everything the child needs automatically is being processed for the child." She goes, "No." She goes, "Unless that child knows that it's being loved, no matter what we do, it will not survive." And I was totally blown away. And I baptized, and I talked to the nurse, and she goes, "As you know, it's always touch and go. It depends on how, the whole problem is the lungs, can they sustain, and have the lungs grow in that situation?" So, being totally moved by the experience and going back and then anointing his mom, and I let her know, and, she had a smile on her face, she felt better, my buddy felt better, I went back home, and I couldn't even sleep the rest of the morning. I was so enamored by it. Because it is true. There is no other way to describe it, that a child in someone's arms and being held and cradled is the greatest sign of reassurance that you're loved and that love will sustain you. Today we celebrate St. Teresa, the child Jesus. And early on as a child, she had a deep, love for flowers and everything else, but she had a deep love for God. And so she went into the Carmelite, and she tried to present what she believed and what she felt, and she was developing this gathering because all she tried to get across people is to place themselves in the hands of God. And to trust that he will never drop you, that he is always there, that he will sustain you, that he'll protect you, that he'll feed you, that he'll provide for you. She understood what that gospel was about today. That unless you can humble yourself like that child and put yourselves in the loving trust of God, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. And that's why she's considered the greatest. John Paul II, because of this simple teaching, declared her a doctor of the church. I know for a fact when you hold a child in your arms that they have absolute, total trust in you. They're not afraid of falling. They simply revel in the moment. When we place our trust, that same amount of trust in God, it is then that we're able to accomplish things far more than what we can possibly think. That's why we allow him to know our sins. That's why we allow him to forgive us. That's why he allows us to know his love. That's why he nourishes us with the Eucharist. That's why he sustains us with the Spirit. Because he wants us to know of his love for him. St. Teresa, before she died, said, "I will, once from heaven, still try to make sure that the people on earth will trust in the love of God." She says it will be like roses falling from heaven in anticipation of her entering the kingdom of God. We often fail to appreciate the simplicity of someone's faith. And that simplicity comes down to, do we truly trust God? Do we truly understand how much he's done for us? Or do we look at ourselves and see ourselves as victims, whereby we need somebody to do something for us, that we deserve some type of compensation for any sense of suffering? St. Teresa did what she did in a short amount of time. She was 15 when she entered. She was 24 when she passed away. She would be so inclined within her prayers, people would say that she literally levitated. And when she prayed, it didn't seem like hours after hours. It seemed like seconds. We can learn from her, as Jesus points out. We too will be reassured. We'll be thinking positive thoughts instead of negative thoughts. And we'll be able to act with joy and, most importantly, love.
Church leaders, may the Holy Spirit fortify them in their gospel mission. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, may Christ's peace touch the hearts of leaders and influencers and lead them to harmony. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the lonely, and those who live on the margins of our communities, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here today, may the Lord bless us and make us holy in his sight. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have died, especially Eleanor Hayes, for whom this Mass is being offered, may they be welcomed into the heavenly kingdom by St. Teresa of the Lizard and all the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear these prayers and grant them according to your will, for we ask them.
us, Lord, and Lord God, all creation, for your goodness we receive the bread of your fruit of the earth, work of human hands, and we come across the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
This means one of our own shared divinity, Christ, the public himself, to share our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine and water of you. Fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite hearts, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me of my sin. Pray that your sacrifice and mine may be accepted to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we proclaim your wonders in St. Teresa, O Lord, we humbly implore your majesty that, as her merits were pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, who are the saints who consecrate themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you and help us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and pray for the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
divinity, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look down on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, within the reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord, kindle in us the force of that love with which St. Teresa dedicated herself to you and longed to obtain your mercy for all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful day, everyone.
Thank you, too.
By the way, Matthew Reed is 23 years old and doing quite well. Which means that he's engaged to be married. So, amazing things happen.
Say, my God, may I be able to defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast him without Satan, and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Take care, everyone.
Today we'll be doing the joyful mysteries in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Amen.
Lord God, pray for our sinners, and now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy
blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
And it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be, the world without end. Amen. O Mother Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, and help especially those most in need of thy mercy. The second joyful mystery, the Visitation. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be, the world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, and help especially those most in need of thy mercy. The third joyful mystery, the Nativity. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for our sinners and now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners and now at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be,
world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, and help especially those who are in need of thy mercy. The fifth joyful mystery, finding in the temple. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. and the Father.